What's up? Do me a favor, like, comment, and subscribe now.
Girl, I still kiss your head in the morning, make you breakfast in bed while you're yawning, and I don't do everything how you want it, but you can't say you're.
Good, y'all, it's your girl Ayana Renee. Don't care what the haters say, I'm gonna mind my business, still get this paper, okay? Yeah, it's me, and today I'm gonna do a story time. It's kind of emotional, then again it's not emotional, but I wanted to do this story time on how I lost my virginity. My boyfriend, he didn't want me to do this because he felt like it was nobody's business, but I just want to make this video clear on how I should help young girls and let no girls know when they're ready to make that decision and don't let them be peer pressure. So, let me scoop back a little bit. Okay, so story time. So really I lost my virginity when I was 14. I didn't really tell nobody. So it all started when I was 16, and it was my first appointment for my, adolescence, because I was getting out of the pediatrics. So I went to the doctor. You know how everything is confidential, and you tell your doctor, like, listen, you know, yes, I'm doing this, yes, I'm doing that. But the thing was, she was like, did you tell your mother? And I'm like, no, I'm going to tell her when I'm ready. I'm going to tell her on my time. And that's the thing. I really wanted to tell my mom on my own, and let her know from my mouth. But you know how they tell your parents, like, to step off the room so you could talk to the doctor, and then the doctor come back with your parents or whatever? That's what happened. So my mom came back, and the doctor, well, the nurse practitioner, she said that she was like, yeah, I knew. Is this something you wanted to tell your mom? No, there's nothing I want to tell my mom. She was like, go ahead. So my mom looked at me like, are you pregnant? And I'm like, no. So then I just start crying because she put me in a predicament that I did not want to be in at this time. And at this time, I was 16, still in high school, even though I had done these things at a younger age than that. 16 when I was officially allowed to have a boyfriend over the house. So meeting this the first boyfriend my mom ever met, whatever. So she was like, are you sexually active? And I just started crying, I really just started crying because I was so angry. I was so angry. So that's the fast forward how my mom found out I lost my virginity. I wanted to tell her on my own, but my doctor, nurse practitioner, made me tell her when I wasn't ready. But anyway, and then my sisters, they felt betrayed because I didn't let them know. They thought I was gonna come to them first, and it was a whole big thing. So fast forward to how I lost my virginity. So I was 14 years old. It was the summer of my 8th grade year when I graduated middle school from 8th grade. And so I was going to go see this boy. He was in a different neighborhood. And the thing was, like, we was together, but we wasn't together. Like, it was just like a back and forth of us talking. And I don't know, I just knew he wasn't gonna take me serious how I wanted him to take me serious, but we was talking, we was pretty cool. So when I went to go see him, you know, we're just chilling. So we're just chilling. So, you know, we chilled in the living room, things like, oh, come to my room. So we was chilling in his room or whatever. So, you know, how, you know, boy, they just start playing with you, play fighting, kissing you, or whatever. That's what happened. So, some way, he got on top of me. This is how I remember, it was so long ago. He got on top of me, And like, I don't, all right, before I say what happened, I kind of say, like, I don't know what you call this, like, and the reason why this situation is dead to me because, you know, it's just a dead situation. I don't know, I was scared, I didn't know what to do, I didn't know what to call it, what happened, everything just happened so fast. So, I don't know if I was like, you know, peer pressure, like molested, or you know what you want to call it, but let me tell you the story. So, he got on top of me, and when he got on top of me, it was just like, you know, kissing, or whatever. But I was scared. I wasn't scared, but I was like, okay. So, you know, he kissing, and he was just like, come on. Come on. I'm just like, no, I don't want to do, like, no. Like, you're just doing too much. Chill out. Please stop. He stopped. So I'm just like, I need to go home. Like, it's getting late. I got to get back home. I take two trains to get home. I think it's time for me to go. So, again, he got back on top of me. He started kissing me. And, so when he's kissing me, he's like, he's trying to, like, pull my pants down. I'm pulling them up. I'm saying no, like, I don't want to do it. I'm saying no, like, I don't want to do it. Like, I'm okay. And he was just like, come on. And I'm just like, no. Like, I kept saying no. But some way, his strength got my pants down. Some way, his strength held me down and still wrapped it up. And it was just like, come on. I'm like, no. And I just got quiet because I just, like, blinked out. And I'm just like, all right, well, you know, it started. You know, it was there. And it was just like, but it was just like, I don't know. It was just like six humps or whatever. And I'm just like, because I wasn't feeling it. I was like, no. That's what happened. That's how I lost my virginity. I didn't want to, not to that person anyway. And I don't know, if I could take it back, I would. I really would, like, because that's not how I imagined it. It wasn't romantic. I wasn't ready yet. And I imagined it to be different, like different, very different. And I just say this. This is just a message for my young girls. Like, you're not ready. Get up. Sock him. Pop. Sock him. Do whatever. Kick string. When you know is a no. Don't get peer pressure to change your mind. If you know it's not right, it's not right. If the first thing you come up here is no, you're not ready. You're not. Because once it's gone, you can't get it back. And then now, me being 23, I finally told my mom how it happened or whatever. So I was just so scared to tell her because I didn't want her to think that it was like a rape thing. It was just like, I feel like it's just a peer pressure. Not molested, but just peer pressure. I was peer pressure into it. It was just a situation. It wasn't supposed to go down. I was just so scared to tell her. I told my boyfriend, he really didn't want me to tell a story. And I'm just like, I just want to help young girls. Like, young girls to know, like, you're not ready. Don't let nobody pressure you into being ready, like, at all. Like, take your time. I promise you, it's nothing. I promise you, it's nothing. Nothing. You something you can, trust me, it's something you can wait for. It's something you can wait for. You know, you hear the songs and the videos and all this stuff. No, honey, boo boo. Wait. I need to practice talking directly into camera, but just wait until you're ready. That's all you gotta do, baby. Just wait until you're ready. And I just want to get this mess. Like, I don't know if I want to say this is a message. Like, I don't know what to say. Like, this was. I just wanted to let y'all know. Like, this is what happened. A little story on how I lost it, so y'all can get to know me better. And hearing this story, I just want to tell y'all, just wait. It's nothing. You're not ready. Don't be peer pressure. if he keep going, just say no, stop him, do whatever, keep streaming, whatever you want to do. And it's crazy because as soon as I left, I was just crying so bad. I cried to my, I called our friends crying. And I don't know what happened. She got mad at me. And it just made me more mad and crying and stuff. But the guy now, you know, he passed away. He died. He died from an illness. I'm not going to say which, whatever. Because he's dead. Let the man rest in peace. But, yeah, but like I said, no means no, and if you're not ready, you're not ready, period. If he keeps going, sock him, period. But anyway, that was a video on how I lost it, which wasn't a good story, but it's just a message just to say you're not ready, period. Do me a favor, like, comment, and subscribe now. But yeah, that was my video. I lost it. So yeah, y'all got any more video suggestions or story times y'all wanna know? Let me know. Period. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'm out. Whoa, 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 hit the wall. Deuce.